to Match the Stars, Gary Murdoch, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Brenda Dixon, Richard Dawson, and Patty Deutsch as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Roberts.
Now we're ready. Did that make too much noise? I'm sorry, I didn't make any agenda. Well, how are you, you?
Well, I'm just wonderful, thank you.
He was talking to all of us.
It's a collective you that I'm referring to.
Oh, I
nice
did
to
not
see you.
Nice to see you too, Albin.
Nice to see you, yes. You're the new girl on the block, aren't you?
Yes.
Yes.
The girl next door.
Shall we give just a brief, polite round of applause there? Now, would you hold my microphone, please?
Of course.
Now, when we have someone new on the program, see, we do a lot of kissing on this show. So,
this is the old wretch on the block.
To properly welcome you,
yes.
Why, we do a lot of kissing on this show. Oh, she's a good girl.
Oh, listen.
That's it. And you,
yes, sir. Who is best?
Oh, really?
Her lips are softer than yours.
Okay.
And you.
Hello.
You had a baby since we saw you.
Yes, I did.
Everything
no,
all right?
She had
everything
a Saint Bernard.
Saint Bernard.
Bite your tongue.
And you named him Max.
Yes.
And he's okay.
Yes.
How much did he weigh?
He weighed 5 pounds, 14 ounces. And now he weighs more than that.
That's the way it should be. Just
Thank
keep
you.
Doing it
oh,
that
then
way.
I must be doing the
but
right
Patty
thing.
Patty weighs 5 pounds and 14 ounces.
Yeah, she does. Now let's say hello to our two players here, Maxine Lambeth and Barbara Guy. This lady has won a lot of money. Do you know how much money you've won?
Millions.
Not quite. $14,650 is a lot of money, isn't it? What are you going to do with all that loot?
I'm going to spend it.
You're going to spend it. That's it. You helped get
economy.
This country out of
right.
this recession. Good. And she's being challenged by Barbara Guybe, who had her first round question and didn't do
Did
too well with it.
Yes.
But you never know how this game goes from one minute to another. We'll give you a question a moment or so, but right now, we want to give you this message, so pay attention. Ready, here we go. Middle of round one. Maxine, this is all yours. Everybody plays. This is their first round question. Long John Silver said, I decided to get rid of that new sailor last night. I caught him blanking me parrot.
Show hasn't changed much.
No, I haven't. But the question is different there. Yes. Mm-hmm. Long John, did you hear all that, Maxine? Long John Silver said, I've decided to get rid of that new sailor. Last night I caught him blanking me parrot. What does that mean?
Oh, that means happy birthday, Kendall, to my friend Kendall Haley. It's just something simple, and I wanted you to also know that the fan is blowing everything apart.
Well, without that fan up there, it'd be too hot up here. Listen, you're not allowed to give personal memos like that.
Oh, I realize that. That's why I didn't do it.
Oh, okay.
She has some very strange fans.
Are you ready, my dear?
Yes, I am.
Okay. Now, here we go over here to Maxine. Long John Silver said, I've decided to get rid of that new sailor last night. I caught him blanking me parrot.
Eating his parrot.
Eating me parrot, eh? What would you say? What would you say? Kissing. You can't kiss a parrot. You get parrot fever. That's very bad. What do you say, Gare?
This wasn't really the sailor's fault. The parrot's very pushy.
Really?
Give us a little kiss.
Oh, kissing. Yeah, you see? And you warned her. What do you say?
Well, actually, he was a little more sadistic than that. He was caught plucking the parrot.
All right. Charles?
Hello, dear.
Notice how quiet and lovely I am.
Yes.
Talking dirty, too.
Talking dirty.
And he was teaching them to say, Polly wants a blank.
That was a very creative, imaginative answer, don't you think, my dear?
Yes, it
yes.
was.
What else do you have to say?
Well,
last night I caught him kissing me parrot, eating me parrot, according to Maxine.
Well, after kissing you, Gene, what could I say?
Kissing! All right. There's a fly drinking your coffee.
Don't kill it. It could be Vincent Price.
Oh, okay. What is a fly? fly get into an air-conditioned studio, that'll always be a mystery to me. Now, last night it caught him eating me parrot, according to Maxine.
All right, that's one for Maxine. Hello, Patty.
Hello.
What do you say?
Well, see, I'm Brett's roommate this week, so yep. It's another parrot plucker.
Another parrot plucker.
So that's... They share a dressing room? Is that what you're trying to tell us, Patty? Okay. Round two coming up, Barbara.
A, please.
You want A?
Yes.
It's over here someplace, isn't it? Right. All right. Anything you say, Barbara? Nanook the Eskimo said.
Yes. Brings back such fond memories.
Yes. Well, wait till you hear this. My wife... No, that wasn't Nanook. He says, my wife is such a big talker that the only way I can get her to shut up is to stick a blank in her mouth. That's Nanook the Eskimo. He says, my wife is such a big talker, the only way I can get her to shut up is to stick a blank in her mouth. Barbara, you think about that? You've got an answer in your head already. I can tell by the look on your face. Right. Okay. All right. Ready.
Oh, I'm ready.
You are?
Yeah.
What are you doing? Artwork there? No. Okay. Now we go over to Barbara Guy. Nanook the Eskimo said, my wife is such a big talker, the only way I can get her to shut up is to stick a blank in her mouth.
Fish.
A fish. I guess. The audience likes her answer.
There's a lot of other answers, though.
There are?
I'm surprised they got fish.
Fish. One for Barbara. Throw the little lady a fish.
That's from a man whose wife is about to give birth any minute, but don't be nervous. Harpoon. I said he's got a little... No, stop that!
A harpoon?
Yes, you harpoon her. She shuts up forever, honey.
Are you feeling a little hostile today?
Oh, golly, gee whizzikers, no.
Not at all.
Mr. Wright has come into my life
at last. Oh, wonderful.
The wrong one all over again, but Mr. Wright nevertheless.
Charles.
This sort of sums up that new romance, an icicle.
An icicle. Barbara Guybe is looking for a fish to stuff in that Eskimo lady's mouth.
I wish I had a fish for her.
You don't?
I don't. I have a snowball.
Snowball. A snowball. All right, Richard.
Best way to stop them talking?
What?
Put a walrus in their mouth.
Oh, boy, that's a lot of blubber.
Certainly.
You, Patty.
And then for dessert, you can have another little piece of fish.
Good for you. Now, Maxine, when we come back from this commercial message, you'll have your second round question, and you'll have to score one celebrity match to tie, two to win. That'll happen right after this. All right. Are you ready? Are you ready wherever you are? Yes, you are. Now, this is yours. Remember, one to tie, two to win. And everyone except Richard participates. At the wedding, Jim said, boy, was that bride rotten. Instead of throwing the bouquet, she threw the blank. A rotten bride. Instead of throwing the bouquet, she threw the blank.
Oh, that's an easy one. I've already finished that one.
All right, Richard.
Top of the world, Gino.
Let's chat while they're writing. What would you like to talk about?
Well, how come you always wear suits?
It's a habit I got into. You see, I'm really an Eastern kid, whatever that means.
Why don't you wear a kimono occasionally?
All right.
He beats everything he hears.
I don't know. All right, everybody ready over there, Maxine? All ready over there. What are you talking? No talking.
In the rain.
Pay attention.
Oh, we're discussing our love life.
Maxine, at the wedding, Jim said, boy, that bride was rotten. Instead of throwing the bouquet, she threw the blank.
The cake.
The cake.
The wedding cake.
The wedding cake? I wouldn't have said that. I thought she was more rotten than that. What do you say?
I wouldn't either. I said the groom.
The groom. Yeah. That's what I would have said, too. This is an audience of superior taste.
Of course, he did have candles in his ears.
Oh, I see.
Fred? Blow them out first.
What do you say?
Don't die down, because I have groom.
Groom. Charles?
You've heard of a brown belt? And a black belt in karate. Well, she being a bride threw the groom because she had a white belt.
A white belt. Come
on.
Do you play? Yes, you do. What do you say?
Yes, yes. I said, what did I say?
We tried.
We cake.
We cake. We tried. Okay. So at this moment, the score is tied 2-2. Now, Patty, if she matches you, she wins the game.
Uh-huh.
If she doesn't match you, we have a tie.
Uh-huh. Are you talking to me?
You, Patty.
I see.
Yes. Are you Patty?
I think
so. You, Patty.
So.
Me, Jane. What do you say?
Oh, are you?
Yes.
Oh, Jean, not Jane.
Jane.
Okay. No, I said that she threw the mother-in-law-to-be.
Mother-in-law-to-be. So the game ends in a tie. And that means we have to go to a tiebreaker. So we'll wipe this slate clean here and push the button and reveal two tie-breaking questions, one for each. The one who scores most will be the winner. Barbara, your choice.
B, please.
B it is. Here we go. Everybody plays in the tiebreaker. After the Lone Ranger spent 2 weeks out on the prairie without a bite of food, he got so hungry he ate blank. You're not going to get me to play your silly little games. I just stand here and read them. That's all I do.
Could you read it again?
Yeah. After the Lone Ranger spent 2 weeks out on the prairie without a bite of food, he got so hungry, he ate...
I know.
You do?
Okay, yes.
Okay. She's got it.
It was Charles who asked you to read the question, and you leaned straight into Brenda's blank.
Hey,
there.
Oh, you're finished.
I'm ready.
You don't need me, do you? You don't need me anymore. Now that you don't need me anymore.
Yes, I do. We're very close friends.
That's true. Okay, we're all set now. Come over here to Barbara. After the Lone Ranger spent 2 weeks out on the prairie without a bite of food, he got so hungry, he ate...
Tonto.
Tonto. They're a bloodthirsty bunch, aren't they? All right, Gary, she says he ate Tonto.
He couldn't have eaten Tonto.
Why?
Everyone knows he's allergic to feathers.
Oh.
Silver.
Silver. Well, Tonto and Silver, I think, are both good answers. Do you have one of the good ones?
Well, you know, I'm constantly... There have been moments in this game show when I've been picked on for my answers and booed by that group out there. And so I very carefully, instead of... My first instinct, needless to say, was Tonto,
right?
I thought, today I'm going to be smart. So I carelessly put Silver...
All right, so
I'm going back to my old ways.
Yes, that's right. Charles.
I agreed with these strange people and put Silver.
Well, now, Tonto is a good answer. Don't be disheartened, Barbara. It was a very good answer. What do you say?
Well, I'm going to get booed.
You are going to get booed?
Yes. I couldn't think of anything, so I said, prairie dog.
All together. Cut.
Oh, well.
That's enough. All right.
This is only my first time.
That's right. She's trying. Tonto
she got
or...
cake the last time.
That's right. Yeah.
She's
okay.
A little prairie dog.
Sure.
You mustn't get upset. Me want no smoking messages from blood brothers. Tonto.
Tonto. All right. You might know that Richard didn't have the good answer. What do you say, Patty?
I said that he ate his kemosabe.
His kemosabe. That's a match. Wow. So that's two for you. Now again, when we come back. 2-3. Hurry back and see what happens. Carry on. If you're ready to carry on, Maxine, this is all yours.
Thank you.
Remember, 2-3. Dumb Dora is so dumb. She puts blank under the arms of her chairs. That's, under the arms of her chairs, she puts blank. That's how dumb Dumb Dora is. Okay.
She puts blank on the arms of
under,
her chair.
Dumb Dora is so dumb, she puts blank under the arms of her chair.
Under the arms.
Under the arms.
Now, you see, under is
deodorant.
The arms. Oh,
sorry.
I can't do that?
No, you can't do that. So we have to throw that question out. And get another one. Give me kisses.
What did Brenda say?
We'll go to the next one. Next tiebreaker. And ask you to make a selection, Maxine.
I'll choose B.
B, all right. Throw those out, if you please. And do these. If you do that again, I'm going to have to belch in the mouth.
All right.
Count Dracula said to the psychiatrist, Doctor, Doctor, I have this terrible problem. Whenever I turn into a bat, people throw blanks. Blanks.
Doctor, I have this terrible problem. Whenever I turn into a bat, people throw blanks.
I I hate that question.
That's a very good question.
Yes, well, maybe if I read...
Dracula said to the psychiatrist, Doctor, I have this terrible problem. Whenever I turn into a bat, people throw blanks.
Oh, okay.
You understand, don't you, little boy?
Mm-hmm. I know he has another problem, too. Arthritis of the tongue.
How's your wife?
She's fine.
Good. Say hello to her, will you?
Any day now.
What? Any day.
Oh, really? Yeah.
Any day now?
Any minute.
Any minute.
Any minute.
It's happening at this very, even as we speak.
Okay. Now, here we are. Maxine. That's enough.
Don't do that. Baby cry.
Count Dracula said to the psychiatrist, Doctor, I have this terrible problem. Whenever I turn into a bat, people throw blanks.
Flames.
Flames?
Well, you know how they did in all those scary movies with the flames.
Oh, they threw flames at him.
I know that's a bad answer.
Everyone knows.
I don't know.
Everyone knows that.
Yeah, what? What do they do here?
Dracula was a flaming bat. Baseballs.
That's a little touch of humor there. I didn't even get it until you said it. Yeah, that's very, very good, Gary. What do you say, Brett?
Oh, I just got his answer. Yeah. Whenever I turn into a bat,
people throw baseballs.
The Willie Mays joke.
Yeah.
Well, I said they threw nets over me.
Threw nets over me. That's a bad one, too, there. Charles.
I feel sorry for me because his wife's going to have a baby.
And she's a veteran.
Yes. Now we're up to Charles.
A stinky answer.
I love it.
Sticks and stones.
Well.
I love
it. Now you, my dear. Brenda, we're up to you.
Yes. Well, the only thing I could think of was a wooden stake. I don't know.
They used to drive a stake in his heart to kill a vampire.
Yeah, that's it. Right.
I don't think you grasped this. Now, show her what a good answer is like, Richard.
Throw balls at the
throw
bat.
Throw balls at the bat. Yeah. Let me... Okay, you stand by for a moment here, and we'll talk to Maxine. Well, Maxine, you're going to have so much money here, and you're going to have so much fun spending it. We're very, very happy for you. You got $14,000.
Thank you. Thank you all. Thank you, Richard.
$14,650. Goodbye. All right. Here we are. Alone at last. I thought you'd never ask me. Now, Maxine, Barbara. Maxine's gone. This is Barbara. She won so many games, I just got used to her being... Listen, you're ready for this where you can win over $5,000. We polled a recent studio audience and we got their best response to this. Pressed blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. If you match the next one, you get $250 in the bottom and you get $100.
Okay.
Whom do you call on here?
Richard.
Pressed duck. Pressed duck. That's a dish.
Okay. Brett. How about pressed ham?
Pressed ham. That's two.
Gary,
have you got one?
My third choice, pressed flowers.
Pressed flowers, yes. All right, so you got pressed flowers, pressed ham, and pressed duck. Would you like to give us one of those as the answer, or think up one of your own?
Okay, I'm going to say this is hard.
Yes, it is.
It's a hard one. Okay, I want to say pressed flowers.
Flowers is the one she's looking for up there. She, of course, hopes it's under the $500 response. But.
Sorry, I can't take this. Shock of it all.
He fell us off his chair here when you chose his answer here. Let's find out what's under the $100 response. Pressed for time, which is a good answer. Did you think of that?
No.
Okay. Looking for pressed flowers, is it under the $250 response? Pressed pants.
They went for a whole different scene.
Yeah, they really did. So far, they haven't given us one answer that we heard up here. Last chance for pressed flowers. Here is the $500 response. Duck.
Richard. I'm sorry.
You didn't blow it. Listen, that was a hard one, as you said.
That was tough.
Listen, you've got the $100, and you're going to play another game here in a moment or so. But right now, we've got this little message for you. Here we are again. No, it's time to say goodbye. Say goodbye.
Goodbye.
Well, we've got 20 seconds to kill. So.
Charles,
what are you doing, Charles?
What am I
what? What are you doing, Charles?
I'm pressing my flowers.
You're squashing your flowers.
Oh, no, it's perfect.
Give that lady
and I
back
am
her
pressing
flowers.
My ham.
Yeah. $2.75. Join us next time. Goodbye.